Hi all, this is Dr. Arpana Chaturvedi from the Department of Information Technology. The subject which I am taking is Fundamental of Web Programming using Java. In this, as we are talking about constructor overloading and constructor handling, how to use constructor in Java. We have already learned that how to use static keyword within unit 2. We will now see that how to use final keyword. What is the importance of final keyword? So the final keyword in Java is used to basically restrict the user. The Java final keyword can be used in various ways, like we can have a final variable, we can use a method as final, we can use final keyword with class. The final keyword can be applied when with variable, a final variable that have no value. It is called blank variable, blank final variable, or uninitialized final variable. It can be initialized in the constructor only, and the blank final variable can be static also, which you need to remember, and which will be initialized in the static block. So suppose you are having a final static variable, then you have to initialize that within the static block. You need to remember this thing. So we see that how to use final variable. If you make any variable final, you cannot change the value of final variable. It is treated as a constant variable. As we used to use const keyword in C++ as well as C, here if you are using final variable, final keyword in front of a variable, then you should remember this thing, that now it is treated as a constant and you will not be able to change its value. And even it can't be changed, because final variable once assigned a value can should be used with that value only during the execution of a program. So for the entire life of a program, the value which is being stored to final variable remains same. You cannot change. Like over here, let's say in a class I am having one final variable, and the name of a variable is total marks, dot marks, and the marks which I have initialized to it is 80. Only the difference is here I have used a final keyword. Now I am having one function, I am executing this and displaying the and reinitializing the value of a variable dot marks as 400. If you run this program, what you see that there is an error which is coming. What it is saying, cannot assign a value to final variable. You cannot assign. This is not allowed. Once the value is being assigned to a constant variable, and it is a constant because you have used a final keyword, you cannot reinitialize its value within the program. And this is the error which proves that yes, it is not allowed. So, or you have to remember this thing. This is another program where what we have done, we are having one function. Now here the method is final. Here the method is final. The name of a method is run, and I am saying that vehicle runs smoothly on the road. Now I am inheriting this class in this derived class cars using extend keyword. Extend is a keyword which we use to basically inherit a class or extend a class from the base class to, while creating a derived class. So this is a base class, and I am from base class I am deriving a new class, that is a car class over here. Here I am overwriting the function. I know that I am having a copy of a function run, because inheritance says this only, that what are the properties and methods this my base class is having, all the properties and methods will be a part of derived class also. So this run method is a part of car class also. Here I am saying cars runs safely on the road. And in the main, as you know that we should make a object of derived class only. So I have made the object of derived class, and using this object I am trying to run the program, and I am calling the member function. So I am calling run member function. But the moment I call, it will say that I cannot override it, because run is a final method. You cannot override the final method whenever you are using a final method in the while applying the concept of inheritance. So this is Java. Similarly, the third way is to use final keyword is by declaring a class final. So if you make any class final, you cannot inherit it. So this is a class student. You can define inside this, you can give any definition. I just left it empty right now. And now I am deriving a class from it and extending student class in BCA. BCA is my derived class, student is my parent class or base class. Here I am having one function run and I am making a object of derived class and trying to call this function run, which is a part of this derived class. The moment I execute it, what it says, you cannot inherit from final student. Final student is what? Final student is a class. You cannot inherit from it. You cannot inherit or generate a derived class from your parent if the parent class is final in nature. So this is what is the importance of final keyword in terms of variable, in terms of method, and in terms of class. So we see one more example. Here we are just explaining that whether final method is inherited or not, and if in case it inherits, can you override it or not. So one example you have seen that you cannot override. Now I am again using this program and trying to run this program which is having a final method, and as we know that final method can be inherited but cannot be overridden. And if you are deriving some class from this, it's a parent class, and you are creating one another class, college student is a parent class, and I am deriving a class IT student from it. Now I will make the object of this derived class using which I will just call the function run. This run is a function. Run is a member function of college STD class, and I have extended from this class ITST. So as per the rule of inheritance, whatever the data member and member function of parent class is over there, those will be a part of derived class also. So what I am doing, using this object of a derived class, I am trying to call the member function of parent class. And see, it is possible. What it means that you can inherit a final class in the derived class, but you cannot override it. In previous class, we have seen that we were trying to override. That is not possible. But as a copy of this class is now a part of this derived class also. That is why using the object of this derived class, I am able to call or use the member function of parent class. Let's see what is blank for uninitialized final variable. A final variable that is not initialized at the time of declaration. You have declared like final in dot marks, but you didn't initialize any value to it. That kind of variable is known as blank final variable. So if you want to create a variable that is initialized at the time of creating object, and once initialized may not be changed, it is useful. For example, PAN card number of an employee. You don't want, once the PAN card number is allocated to any person or any employee, that is not editable. You cannot change later on. To such kind of variables which are required in the program whose value cannot be changed once initialized, then it is must that, or it is better, or it is suggested that that kind of variable should be declared as a final variable. It can be initialized only in constructor. How? Let's say this is a variable. No value is being initialized over here. Only we have declared a final variable. At the time of declaration, we didn't initialize any value to it. So to such kind of final variable, if you want to initialize the value to it, we know that the value can't be changed, but there should be some initial and valid value that we can do at the time of creating a constructor. So here there is an example wherein we are having one class student result. I'm having one final variable which is termed as blank variable, as value is not been initialized to it. Now I have to initialize some value to it. When can I initialize? In the constructor. This is the constructor. The name of a class and constructor is same. This constructor is default constructor. I have initialized value to the final variable, and this I can do only once I have displayed it. Now the moment I created the object, I see that the value has been initialized and the output is 70. And the output is coming because while creating or initializing a value in the constructor, I have used one set of statement, that is system.out.println. Just to show you, it is not mandatory. This value can be used anywhere for computation purpose. Just to let you know that whether the value is being initialized or not using constructor, I have written this statement over here. Now, static blank final variable. Just now we have seen final variable, which is also termed as blank if not initialized. We can have static final variable also. So a static final variable that is not initialized at the time of declaration is known as static blank final variable. Now in this case, if you have to initialize, because there is a variable which is a final type, but now it is static also. If it is not static, we can initialize its value in the constructor, but in case it is static also, then how we'll give the initial value to it? Because we know this thing that the value can't be changed, but there should be some meaningful value. So the value we can give in a static block. This is a static block. So to static final variable, the value can be initialized only in the static block, as I have done over here. I have initialized this roll number, which is static and final in nature. The value is 50, and I tried to display this in the main. I am able to, and I am getting the output as 50. So here we learned that using static block, we can declare or initialize. We can initialize the value to static and final variables. This is another example. In this, we are trying to pass a final variable as an argument. So if you declare any parameter as final, you cannot change the value of it. Here is an example. I'm having one class CQ. In this, I'm having one Q function. I'm passing final variable to this as an argument, and it is returning some value to me. Here I'm trying to change the value of this passed argument, but the argument which is coming over here is final in nature. So if I try to manipulate, I can't. I can use it here. I can find out the cube of the number which is final in nature, but I cannot reinitialize the value in the same variable, or I cannot manipulate some value. So the moment I try to do this, I have passed the variable value from here. This num go and get copied in num, but the error will come. That is, you cannot change the value of final variable. So this is the another concept, that this is allowed, that you can pass a argument of final type, but you cannot change its value. This is all about final. Thanks a lot for watching my video. In next class we will talk about this keyword. Thank you. Have a nice day.